Hello students, welcome to the video on BJT fabrication process. So we will be seeing all the steps involved in fabricating a single BJT. So coming to the fabrication process, we know that it involves many operations. So the first thing is the basic junction. It is an isolated bipolar junction fabrication process is known as the standard buried collector process. That is, the standard buried process is the primary process used in the fabrication of analog and powerful bipolar ICs with power supplies exceeding about 15 volt. For digital ICs, the SBC process has been replaced by the further fabrication process using other isolation techniques. So the first thing formed for the formation of the transistor is the oxide growth. So here we can see that we will be having an p-type substrate, a lightly doped p-type silicon wafer, pure wafer is taken and it is used as a substrate for the fabrication of an NPN transistor. On this wafer, a silicon dioxide layer is grown by heating the wafer in oxygen or steam in a furnace. That is, we are trying to make the highly oxidized steam to pass through this surface so that the top layer will be coated with the silicon dioxide. This layer will act as a mask for all the further steps of the fabrication process. So oxidization is a process by which a silicon dioxide layer is formed. So the next one is a buried layer formation. So buried layer formation is nothing but a window is open on the oxide layer, that is the silicon dioxide layer, which is formed by the process of photolithography. So we will be seeing what is meant by photolithography later. Antimony ions, that is the pentavalent impurities that are used for an N layer is implanted into the substrate to form a heavily doped N buried layer, also known as a subcollector. So here the N layer will be forming it as a collector, and the function of this buried layer is to reduce the resistance of the collector of the bipolar transistor. The masking layer which is present is then removed by wet etching. So this is the second step. The first one is we will be forming a silicon dioxide layer. The next one is we will be forming the buried layer. So the next step is the N-type epitaxial growth layer is grown on the top of the silicon layer. The epitaxial growth process results in high quality silicon layer with the same crystal structure as the original silicon wafer. The doping is chosen so as to give the desired collector base junction breakdown voltage. The thickness is chosen so that the collector to base junction of the spacer region just extends across the entire epitaxial layer when the maximum collector to base junction reverse bias voltage is applied. So the fourth step is the masking oxide layer. Now epitaxial layer is formed on which again N silicon dioxide is formed. So now the windows are etched in the oxide using the photolithographies. Now the boron ions are implanted into the exposed part to form the p-type region. So here now initially we have formed the collector region, which is an N, and then we will be forming the p-type region. The boron ions are driven through the epitaxial layer by thermal diffusion and until they reach the substrate. So the islands of the epitaxial layer will be formed, thus effectively isolating the transistors which are to be built in the epitaxial layer from one another. So here we can see that this is a p-type substrate, and then we had the N plus buried layer, and this is a subcollector, and then we had the epitaxial layer on which we will be having the p-type base. So the boron is used for the base. So now a thermal oxide is grown and a window is opened in the oxide by the photolithography. The boron ions are implanted into the exposed part of the epitaxial layer with a sufficient dose to convert it to a p-type region. Now a p-type base region is formed, and it is further diffused into the epitaxial layer to form the base of the transistor. Now what is photolithography? The process involved in photolithography. So here you will be having the silicon substrate. For example, I want to use, or I want to make the substrate, or I want to dope some either N-type or P-type impurities inside my substrate. So I have to go for the photolithography. So what is photolithography is, initially I will be having my silicon material. On the silicon material, I will be performing the oxidation to form SiO2. On the oxide layer, I will be forming a layer of photoresist. Photoresist is a coating material. So after oxidation and deposition of the photoresist, we will have an optical mask. Optical marks is nothing but the pattern with the openings where I want to make the contact. So after this patterned optical mask, I will be I will be passing the ultraviolet rays. So when the ultraviolet rays when my device is exposed to the ultraviolet rays, then we will be having an hardening of the material. Polymerization will take place. So here we can see that the layer which is not exposed will be having a hardened resistance, and the remaining layer will be having in soft process. So the exposed resist will be hardened and the remaining will be soft. So the exposed layer can be then removed by the chemical or plasma etching. After development and etching of resist, this will be the pattern, this will be the device concept. Now the hardened resistance can be removed by means of some acid. So here now after this we can see that only this part of my oxide is removed. So this is the final result after the removal of the resist. So for each process, whenever we want an opening or whenever we want a pattern in my device, I will be going for the photolithography process. So the next step, so we have formed the base region, already a collector is formed. So the next is the emitter formulation. So a thermal oxide is grown and windows are opened by the process of photolithography. A heavy dose of phosphorus is implanted into the exposed layer. So the phosphorus will be resulting in the form of N region. It converts the part of the base into which it is implanted into an N plus region, forming the emitter. The N plus region is also formed in the exposed part of the N type collector region also, in order to facilitate the formation of a good contact. So the N plus region indicates that it is a heavily doped emitter region where which will act as a source of the charge carriers. After emitter is formed, all the three layers or regions are formed. Now I need to make a contact should be established. So to contact window opening, again a thermal oxide is grown, and using photolithography, windows are etched in the oxide to expose the part of emitter base and collector region. This is to take out the lead from it. This is to allow the metal contacts to be made to these regions. Now after this, the aluminium is evaporated. So aluminium is a metal which is used to make and establish the contact. Aluminium is evaporated into the vapor by vacuum evaporation. The excess aluminium is etched away using photolithography, leaving only those that are need to make the contact with the emitter base and collector on the transistor. In an integrated circuit, metal tracks may be defined to interconnect the various part of the transistors to the other circuit element. So here in this diagram, we can consolidate and we can see that you will be having the p-type substrate. So which is the base of this device, and then you will be having the n-type n plus buried layer. This buried layer is used to reduce. It is used to reduce the resistance of the device, followed by the epitaxy layer, the growth of the epitaxy layer, and then I need to induce my base region. So base region is a p-type material which I will be having here, and also the followed by formation of the emitter region. So the emitter region is formed, and then I will be having the metal contacts established here. So this metal contacts will be used as one is for the emitter, this is for the emitter base, and then I will be having the collector. So this epitaxy layer will reduce the overall resistance of the collector region. So this is how a BJT will be fabricated. So here we will be seeing the process flow as a sequence. So p-type substrate will be there, and then I will be having an n plus buried collector implant, followed by the epitaxy layer. The epitaxy layer will be followed by the buried collector will be induced here, and then we will be going for the diffusion process for the isolation. So this will be isolated, and then we will be having the base region formed, and also my emitter diffusion process will be happening. So on this, the oxidation process followed by the contact openings. So after contact opening, the metallization process will take place where I can make the contact. So this is the overall bipolar process flow. So thank you.